Hello, everyone. Again, my name is Brad Agostinelli. I'm the team director at the Burbank YMCA in Reading. I'm just here again to talk about what we have going on in our next session. So like I mentioned in the last podcast, the Y year kind of runs in sessions, and basically it's every 2 months. And our next session begins on Monday, October 31st. And again, our facilities in Reading with the Burbank YMCA, right in between Birch Meadow Elementary School and Coolidge Middle School, and across from Reading Memorial High School. So a couple of things that we have coming up in the next couple of months. So I mentioned the session begins on October 31st, and it ends on December 18th. And usually around Christmas and New Year's, there is a two-week interim period. So that's when the session will end, and then the new stuff after that doesn't start up until the turn of the calendar year in January. So just got a couple branch items for you, just the general news about our facility, and then I'll go into some items about the teen program, because that is the department in which I work and what I focus on. So first, just wanted to mention that our new executive director, our previous executive director, accepted a position. Irene Collins accepted a position in our association, because we're part of the YMCA of Greater Boston. So she accepted a new position there and now works in Boston. And our new executive director's name is John Feudo. He started actually yesterday, 2 days ago, Monday, October 24th. So we're glad to have him. I'm just going to lend a little introduction to him. I had actually worked a couple times with him, because he, for 14 years, he said he worked in the Reading Recreation Department. He worked for the town of Reading for a long time. He grew up in Reading. He now lives in Tewksbury. So he knows the community well, and we're looking forward to having him, and I'm looking forward to working with him as we move along. So if you know him, if you don't know him, feel free to stop in and say hi. I know he's in the process of meeting everyone, and he's enjoying getting to know the facility and our Y community. And of course, we serve Reading, but also North Reading, Wakefield, Wilmington, and Stoneham, and people outside of that. So feel free to stop in and say hi. Just make his welcome a little warmer. So in addition to that, again, the new session, we have a whole slew of new swim lessons, sports programs, enrichment programs, and other stuff going on. So with the new session, we usually have family events. Registration has been going on for a couple weeks now. So if you or your child would like to sign up for any programs, feel free to go do that online at ymcaboston.org/programs, or you can stop into the Y at the welcome desk. They'll be happy to help you out with that. Specifically, a couple family events coming up in addition to our general programming. Usually at the end of November, after Thanksgiving and through Christmas, we run a Christmas tree sale. Well, actually, the Y Service Club runs a Christmas tree sale. The Y Service Club is an auxiliary group whose mission is to support YMCAs. And our Y Service Club does an annual Christmas tree sale. This is their 51st annual sale. And basically, the proceeds come back to the YMCA, to our annual fund. The sale takes place starting after Thanksgiving on North Avenue in Wakefield, on Lake Quanapowhat, right across from the municipal light building there. And the hours are usually around 10 or 11 in the morning until between 7 and 9 at night. We have wreaths that are decorated and not decorated. We have Christmas trees of different sizes. I believe they're all from Nova Scotia, and they're balsam fir trees, if anyone is a tree enthusiast and cares about that stuff. They'll be there for starting after Thanksgiving through Christmas. And feel free to come and check it out. Sometimes we have snacks and hot chocolate there too. So it's nice to walk by the lake, by a tree. We'll be happy to, we're happy to receive the support in any way you can. And the other prices also vary, again, for like the small Charlie Brown sized trees, anywhere from $5 or $10 all the way up to $50 or $60, depending on the size. So feel free to come by and stop for that. Again, that begins after Thanksgiving, and that is on North Avenue on Lake Quanapowhat, across from the Wakefield Municipal Light Building in Wakefield. So another family event we have going on in the next session is our Gingerbread House building event. That's on Saturday, December 3rd. And generally, we've been doing that for a couple years, but how that works is you can sign up with your family. It's usually a small fee, $5 or $10. You can come build a gingerbread house, take it home. We have pizza, meet other families, bring some friends. It's usually a nice time. It'll be, there are two different sessions. One starts at 12:30 p.m. The other one starts at 1:45 p.m. on that Saturday, December 3rd. So feel free to stop by. We do prefer that you sign up ahead of time because last year, I believe it did fill up. The room is usually full. So, come build a gingerbread house. You can bring it home and, meet some new people and build some community here at the Y in the next month or so. So those are the general highlights for our building. Not specifically the teen department, but just stuff we got going on, especially family events. And now I'll kind of move on to the teens here because that is my job. So again, my job as the teen director is to be a resource, be available to serve and provide things for the teens, basically grade 6 to 12, middle through high schoolers, to help them become the best versions of themselves, take the next step, spend their time positively, whatever that looks like. So to that end, we have a couple things going on, a couple of continuing things and a couple of new things this session. So as I mentioned in the last podcast, we are actually, this year, we have a new teen center that is open for grades 6 to 12, and it's free to drop in for YMCA members. Although, because it's new, we're trying to attract attention. If any teen is not a Y member and wants to check it out, they can stop in for a couple times and see what it's like. Basically, it's a space we have at our building at the Y where teens can come, hang out with friends, watch a movie, play video games, read, do homework. We have snacks there too, so just a place where they can come together. They know they're welcome, and like I said, they can find ways to spend time positively. It's always staffed by myself or another volunteer or YMCA staff member. And right now the hours are Tuesdays, Wednesdays, and Thursdays from 5 to 8 p.m. Those hours are subject to change. We talked last time how ideally we would like to have it open right after school because, especially with the high school, middle school there, it'd get a lot more traffic, but we do share it with our after-school program for the middle schoolers there, so that's why we can't open it to the public until 5 p.m. But after that, I'd welcome anyone to come and check it out, check out the building, see if we have anything to offer them there, and anyone can drop in and definitely talk to me if you have any questions about that. But that's ongoing, and that's something that we're really trying to get out there to be of service to the community, just to give any middle and high schoolers a chance to be involved and find their place in our community. So a couple organized programs now. This session, our teen sports league is indoor soccer, which will be in our gymnasium starting November 4th and ending on December 9th, except for the Friday after Thanksgiving. Basically, chance for kids to work on their game, play with their friends, be a little competitive, nothing too intense, and that'll be there to ref and keep the score. And then at the end, depending on how many teams we have, we'll have a playoff round for prizes too. So that starts Friday, November 4th. For YMCA members, it's $25, and for non-members, it is $50. And feel free to, again, reach out to me if you have any questions. Again, a lot of our sports leagues, and this one specifically is for grades 8 to 10, although if a teen is a little younger and they want to participate, they're most welcome to. A lot of them aren't super competitive, aren't super intense, but again, just gives the kids another opportunity to stay active, meet other people, build friendships, and work on their game a little bit, especially if they're a soccer player. So again, fall session 2, teen indoor soccer for our sports league. We also do teen special events once or twice every session. This session is a Nerf war, so for any Nerf enthusiasts out there, I know I was growing up playing in our basement. If you want a little bigger space, some more resources, we're having one at the Y. The gym will be closed only for teens for this purpose to have a Nerf war. It's open to grades 6 to 10, Saturday, November 12th at 1:30 to 4 p.m. I do supply some Nerf bullets, but the kids can bring any Nerf guns they may have. The bullets need to be foam or some sort of soft material. We also provide eye protection and snacks as well. So if they want to have some fun, take a couple hours, be active, again, meet other kids. We do have a nice group that usually comes once or twice a year. as we when we organize it, and it is pretty fun just to be able to strategize and play, have a little Nerf War with more people in a bigger space. So again, that's on Saturday, November 12th. We also have our Leaders Club that is ongoing, and I forget if I mentioned it last time or not, but Leaders Club at the Y is basically a group, a weekly meeting group, whose goal it is to learn leadership skills, build positive relationships with the other, with other teens, and contribute to the YMCA and surrounding community, and just build up general virtue, personal virtue. So we have two groups, the Junior Leaders Club, which is the middle school group, grade 6 to 8, that takes place at 6 p.m. on Wednesdays, and then the high school group, Leaders Club, takes place at 7 p.m. The meetings are an hour long, and they take place in the teen center. So anyone's welcome to drop in. It's free. Usually meetings, we have a little discussion, quote to talk about, virtue to talk about. Then we go into business. So right now we're working on a fundraiser for the teen center because the kids want to have a couple goals that they want to buy and contribute to the teen center. So working on fundraisers for that. We do other service projects in the community. Last year, we actually donated a tree to the Parker Festival of Trees at Parker Middle School for the Reading Educational Foundation. So projects like that, and again, a lot of the, some of the meetings are just hangout time, some games, some group games, team building games. So if anyone's, and this program is free, and actually if the goal of the program is for the teens to commit for the whole year. So we build up every week. You know, we try to build something throughout the whole year, which is why it is a commitment. But again, nothing that we want to overburden the kids with. And right now, if it's not for them, that's fine. You know, we just want to add things that are positive and can help them live fulfilling lives at this point, at this stage in life. So if it doesn't work, if they're too busy, have a lot going on, that's fine. They can drop in anytime throughout the year and participate. But if they do want to commit for the whole year, they get a free teen membership if they don't already have one. And it lasts as long as they stay active in the club. So again, that is Leaders Club on Wednesday evenings at the Teen Center at the Y. And finally, just a couple of volunteer opportunities, because I know a lot of the kids, especially in high school, are looking to get service hours for whatever reason, for high school, for National Honor Society, for religious education. So we actually do have a lot of open opportunities right now coming up. We have, you know, all of our special events, so the Christmas tree sale for the Y Service Club and also the Gingerbread House event. We need volunteers for those. Right now I'm looking for a rock wall assistant. We also would like tutors and assistants for our after-school program. I know these are available to teens. And just general cleaning and filing that, you know, may be tedious, not too glorious, but they do help the building and the staff run more efficiently and effectively. So if any teen is interested in any of these opportunities, whether volunteer or any other teen opportunities, the Teen Center, Leaders Club, Nerf War, Sports League, anything else, just want to generally get involved in the Y, questions about membership, you can feel free to let me know. Membership is $15 a month for a teen, and for families, one or two adult households, adults, it's higher, but for just a teen, on a membership, it would just be $15 a month. So anyone can reach out to me with questions about that or any other programs. Again, this is Brad Agostinelli, the teen director at the Burbank YMCA. My office number is 781-909-7116. I could also be reached out to by email, bagostinelli, which is my last name, at ymcaboston.org. So I appreciate the outreach, appreciate the involvement, and like I said, I'd be glad to welcome any teen to our building, get them involved in any way I can. So feel free to reach out to me, and until next time, have a good fall.
This podcast is part of the NORCAST Podcast Network. Check out more podcasts at podomatic.com/NORCAM.